Insight to the Spirit, a Bible study brief series from Shorter Community AME Church. This insight shares the subject, The Great Commission. We listen to Karen Ivey and Adam Dempsey.
Matthew 28, verses 18 through 20. And Jesus came to them and spake unto them, saying,
All authority hath been given unto me in heaven and on earth. Go ye therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them into the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Let the church, let them say amen. If you believe the word, let the whole church say amen. God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Lift your hands, lift your hands. God has spoken, so let the church say amen. No, thank you, Lord. God has spoken, so let the church say amen.
In today's scripture lesson, we find the remaining 11 disciples of Christ gathered around the resurrected Jesus in order to receive important instructions from him. Jesus tells his disciples what he expects them to do while he's away. For 3 long years, the disciples followed Jesus throughout the land of Judea. They heard his words. They received his messages. They witnessed firsthand the many miracles, signs, and wonders he openly performed for all to see. They even bore witness to the greatest miracle of all, his resurrection from the dead. Yes, Jesus' disciples were with him throughout his entire earthly ministry. They were even empowered by him, according to Matthew 10, 1 through 42, to do the very thing that he was doing. But now, Jesus is with his disciples this one last time to bid them to continue to do the same work he empowered them to do before when he was physically with them. But now, since Jesus is about to go to the Father, his presence will no longer be with the disciples as before. Instead, the disciples will receive God's presence in the form of the Holy Spirit, who will enable them to continue on in the good work that Jesus empowered them to do. Now, saints, in order to gain a fuller picture of this great commission, it is important to read this scripture text, Matthew 28, 18 and 20, with the other passages like Mark 16, 15 through 19, Luke 24, 45 through 49, and finally Acts chapter 1 and 2 in their entirety. Our scripture text, Matthew 28, 18 through 20, will provide us with an overview of what we, as the body of Christ, the church of the living God, should be doing in the absence of our Lord, yet in the power and presence of his Holy Spirit. The first thing that Jesus commissions us to do is to make disciples of all nations. This means we are to go out into the world and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ and compel people to give themselves wholly to the Lord. Now, the Greek word for disciple is metatuo. This word suggests the deep shaping of one's character and the cultivation of one's worldview through a close, intimate, personal relationship with a teacher or father figure. So we are to go out into the world and make sincere followers of Christ who seek to emulate Jesus and become partakers of his life. Next, after making disciples for the Lord, we are to train them. Yes, we are to train them in the way that they should go, equipping them to lead godly lives. Indeed, according to 2 Peter, the first chapter, third verse, God's divine power, that is his Holy Spirit, has given us everything for life and godliness. Now, in addition to this Holy Spirit, God has empowered and enabled his church, according to Ephesians 4:17 through 13, to equip and prepare God's people for works of service. Now finally, after making disciples and training them in the way that they should go, we are to teach them to obey the commands of our Lord. Now, in order to teach them to obey the Lord's words, we must first teach them the Word of God. We are to teach the Word of God, the Holy Bible, to God's people so that it takes root in their heart and mind, so that they can heed and obey it to their benefit and God's glory. Yes, saints, let us individually and collectively endeavor to fulfill this great commission. Let us make disciples for our Lord. Let us train them in the way that they should go, teaching them to read and obey God's holy and precious word. Yes, saints, this is the great commission. This is the work of God's church. Hallelujah and amen. Let us pray. Holy and precious Lord, strengthen us as we go out into a dying world, preaching your gospel, drawing every soul unto you. Help us to train your people to live for you. Help us to teach them to heed or obey your words, thus building up your kingdom to your glory. In Jesus' name this we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Reverend Michael Gallant. To gain the full value of this online Bible study, go to shorteramechurch.org. Click on the link, Insight to the Spirit, Study Materials, The Great Commission. Experience uplifting, inspirational, spiritual insights like this Sundays at Denver Shorter Community AME Church. Reverend Timothy E. Tyler,